Hi everyone, welcome to the third video where we will finish to model our Game Boy character. In the previous video we have finished the front cover. Let's take this loop, duplicate it and press P to separate it so that it will serve as the profile curve for our next object, the back face of the casing. Since we run through a lot of editing on the front cover, I have a lot of points that are useless, so you can select them and click X and choose Dissolve Vertices so that we will get rid of all the additional points we have created before and that are useless here. Once done, you will have your Game Boy profile with only 5 vertices per corner. Now inside you, let's move those vertices to align them with the blueprint. Then we will switch to top view and we will move our image reference so that we have the back side aligned with the model. So I figured that the blueprint was reversed regarding the back side, but it doesn't really matter since we have already created the main profile and the other parts are symmetrical. The idea here is to create the shape of the different layers of the back case. Still in edit mode, I've added a simple plane and I'm just scaling it so that it fits the first layer. Then I've created a second one and I'm also editing it very basically so that it follows the different size. Then we can control shift B, bevel the corner of the first plane, trying as usual to match the blueprint and using 4 cuts to get 5 vertices on each corner. Then we will use the same technique as in the previous video to create the face loop, using the insert face, pressing I and then getting rid of the inner face. But first I will align those with the blueprint. Then go back into view, press I, move inward and delete the inner face. This way we have defined the different layer of the back case. I can now extrude those vertices vertically, hold Ctrl to snap them onto this vertex. This will allow me to make sure that the surfaces are aligned and fill using the F2 add-on. I can now create the face loop for the top part, so as usual I will select it by double clicking, then press F to fill, I to insert face and X to get rid of the inner and gone face. Now our goal will be to fill and connect those two areas following the curvature of the surface. This can be pretty tricky since the surface is not homogeneous. We have one corner that is broader or larger than the other ones. Doing it by hand, even if we have time, will be pretty complicated. Thankfully, there is an automated tool to do this. With those two edge loops selected, I will press Ctrl E and select Ridge Edge Loop. And then I will increase the number of cuts. This way, Blender will automatically add loop cuts and blend the two surfaces. But the problem is that the upper part is also getting curved while I want it to be straight and the lower part curved. And this is because, from what I understand, the bridge head loop will interpolate the first surface with the second one. Since both surfaces are horizontal, it creates this weird or unwanted interpolation on the top part. To fix it, we just need to create a temporary vertical surface. So I will get rid of the inner vertex loop, extrude those vertically, select everything and recalculate the normal by pressing Shift N. That's important to avoid bug, and then with those two loops selected I will press Ctrl E and reprocess the bridge edge loop. Increase the number of cuts and play with the smoothness factor to tweak the shape of the profile. Now I can recreate the top part by getting rid of this loop, fill this face, use the insert face, get rid of this top face, and then I will make this edge loop slide so that it fits the vertical extrusion, and I can now extrude those vertices vertically and add some bevels on the edges that need to be added. Now we just need to create our supporting edge loop, and finally we will fill the back face of the case by using the grid fill tool, pressing Ctrl F. To create those supporting edge loops, since the different sides are not regular, I will use the loop cut tool and I will manually enter the value of the offset. So I will set it to 0.9 or minus 0.9 on every single side so that I'm sure I will get an even distribution of my edge loop. Finally, I will select the inner loop, press Ctrl F and use the grid fill tool, and I will just align those two edge loops to get a nice topology. Then back into object mode, I will select both case and press Ctrl J to join them into a single mesh. I will also revise the depth of the different button recess since I've made them a bit too deep. Then I will create a small sphere for the LED, and to avoid any shading issue due to the pole on the top of the UV sphere, I will just rotate it. I can now work on the limbs of my character. So I will start with a simple sphere that I will set to 32 segments with 16 rings, and I will then in edit mode cut it in half. I will make sure first in object mode that I press Alt G so that it's aligned with the world and aligned with our Game Boy origin. This way I will be able to use a mirror modifier and work only on one side of the limbs. Since the mirror modifier uses by default the origin of an object to create the mirror part, it's easier and more obvious to work with an unrotated model and with an origin point in the center of the document. For the arm and leg, I will add a Bezier curve and then I will scale it down, and in the curve option, I will slightly increase its resolution and I will increase the bevel depth. This will give our curve a bit of thickness. Then in edit mode, I will align the curve by first rotating it and then scaling the different point on the Y and X axis by zero. Then I will place the knee more or less in the middle of the position between the foot and the body, and then I will slightly bend it by rotating those control points. To create the arm, I will simply duplicate the leg curve and rotate it by 180 degrees on the X axis, and then in edit mode I will slightly revise its shape. Finally, I will snap the cursor to the end point and add a simple sphere. Since the model will be then subdivided using a subdivision modifier, a 16 segment 8 ring sphere is way enough resolution wise. Now to join everything together, I need to convert those curves to meshes. So I will go to Object, Convert and select Mesh from Curve. Now I can select the hand, the limbs and finally the foot and press Ctrl J to join them into a single object. Then I will be able to add a modifier, mirror modifier. And if you get an offset into your mirror, it means that the origin point is not aligned with the world. So in object mode, you just need to press Ctrl A, apply location. Back in edit mode, I've selected the sphere I've used to create the hand and I've cut it into half, and I will simply create a finger shape based on this. So it's just an extrusion, a couple of loop cuts, and then I will input it into the sphere. Using the Alt S shortcut, you can shrink or inflate those shape, and then it's just a matter of duplicating them and positioning them as you want to create an end shape. Once I'm done, I will name the body and the limbs properly and I will keep them separated because it will make our life easier when it comes to rigging. This is the end of the modeling chapter. If you like this video, please press the like button and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.